Good evening. Has anyone here, does anyone here, I'll raise your hand if you know a truck driver, how about a cab driver, an Uber driver, how about an insurance agent? Yeah? Okay. Their jobs may be at risk. In fact, there will be 1.6 million truck drivers that will lose their job one day. Over a million Uber drivers, cab drivers, Lyft drivers will lose their jobs. In fact, over 4 to 5 million people will lose their jobs. Okay, what's the cause of all this? Self-driving cars, self-driving trucks, self-driving tractors, and other self-driving equipment. But let's go back. Let's go back to the late 1800s. Let's take a look at New York, what life was like in New York. There were over almost 200,000 horses in New York City alone. Each of them dropping an average of 22 pounds of manure each day. Thousands of workers had to keep track of it. Thousands of workers had to go in and scoop it up. Flies were everywhere. Disease was rampant. In fact, as many as 20,000 New Yorkers died every year as a result of disease. In addition, 15,000 horses dropped dead from being overworked. And then came the automobile. Guess what the saying was when the automobile came out? Horses bite, but drivers kill. That's what they said. Horses bite, but the drivers kill. And kill they did. In 1900, there were 8,000 cars in the United States. By 1920, there were 8 million cars in the country. And kill they did. Last year, it is estimated that 1.3 million people lost their lives as a result of an auto accident in the world. 20 to 50 million accidents where there's injuries in the world. In 2015, in the United States alone, 38,300 people lost their lives and 4.4 million auto accidents. But what if we could change all that? What if we could change it? What if we could reduce accidents by 75%? What if we could save 30,000 lives each and every year? Welcome to the world of self-driving cars. It's coming. You may ask, how do we save that many lives and how do we reduce that many accidents? Well, the advances in technology of radar, LIDAR, GPS, the car's ability to sense their surroundings, the car's ability to communicate with other vehicles, that's how they do it. You'll save tons of lives. Now, there are some concerns with self-driving cars. You've probably all heard them. Number one is software reliability. What if a hacker can get in and take over the control of the car? Okay, what about the public's reluctance to lose control? What about the inability to, we talked about the public's inability to lose control. There are other issues. What about severe weather? What if these sensors can't distinguish whether there's still one ice on them, on what to do? Oh yeah, there are some concerns. Who's who being liable in case of an accident? Would it be the driver, the person riding the car? Would it be the software? Would it be the auto manufacturer? Who knows? But there's some concerns. But think about the positive. It is estimated that 75 to 80% of the public will no longer own a car. Think about that for a second. Think about the inefficiency of the automobile. You guys and I, we have loan payments. We have maintenance expenses. We have car insurance. We have taxes. We have gasoline expenses. We have all these things that we pay for the car to sit idle, or actually parked 95% of the time. So, how will you access a car? You will call up Enterprise. You call up Uber. You call up Lyft, or any one of dozens of companies that will be coming on the scene. You'll have a car at your location in 5 to 10 minutes. 5 to 10 minutes, you'll have a car there. Well, that's pretty cool, having a car there in 5 to 10 minutes. There are other some real important benefits. By the way, what can you do while you're riding in a car? Just think the possibilities. You could text or talk on your cell phone. We're doing that now already, everyone. You can learn a foreign language. You can work. You can actually work. And just think, you might even get to work on time for a change with a self-driving car. The possibilities are endless on what you can do with a self-driving car. But one of the real decisions that will impact the self-driving cars will be what the regulators say. The regulators are going to have an influence. Just think, when the regulators hear that we can save 30,000 lives in the United States, and we can save 3 million, or reduce accidents by 3 million, that's going to impress them. What if they, many people believe that software, hardware, aftermarket will be cheap. So what if you have that 1965 GTO that you love to drive? What if the regulators say, you got to put this on that car? You can't drive that car. Because you know what's going to happen. You know what's going to happen. When you have non-self-driving cars, and the rest of us out there on the roadways, we all drive 5 to 15 miles over the speed limit. Admit it, you do. A self-driving car can't do that. So we're going to have this issue where the cars are on the highway, and with people who are driving and people with self-driving cars, it's going to be a problem. So the regulators are going to take control. So you have that GTO and you want to take it out, maybe, just maybe, you're going to have to put this auto-driving modulator on your car. Okay, here's another benefit of self-driving cars. It doesn't matter if you're underage, overage, old, intoxicated. It doesn't matter. You could be drugged, blind, anything. As long as you get that car, it could take you anywhere. Now, I'm 69 years old. In about 20 years, when I'm a senior citizen, I've heard that. When I'm a senior citizen, I'm going to have a chauffeur. My chauffeur will not be like Miss Daisy, who has a human chauffeur. Mine will be a robot. It will take me anywhere, any place I want to go at any time. As long as it has me back home by 9 o'clock so I can go to bed. But think about that for a second. The opportunity of having your own chauffeur. Now my wife and I were driving recently, or I was driving, my wife was driving. We were stuck in traffic. We were heading to an event. 2 o'clock in the afternoon on the freeway. So I was driving along. We were late for the event. What I see in front of me? Stoplights. became extremely frustrated. And I said, what is wrong with these crazy people? You know, this is Saturday afternoon, 2 o'clock. What's going on? Why do we have traffic jam? So my wife, she said, now, how soon are we going to have self-driving cars? And I said, oh, it'll be 4 to 5 years. And she said, really? 4 to 5 years? She says, I can't wait. Because you're self-driving me crazy.